Good evening and welcome to tonight's game between the Cochrane-Fountain City Pirates and your Emmanuel Lutheran Lancers.
Should be a pretty good game here tonight. We have Cochrane-Fountain City, who always seems to put together a very good team. They're a very young team this year. They only have two seniors and two juniors. So the rest of the team is sophomores and freshmen. Very young team, but looks like a pretty good team. And then you have Lancers coming off that win against Lincoln, was it, on Tuesday?
Yeah, Lincoln.
65-56 coming off. They've had a really strong year, they always have, with Emily Hyde and Joe Meyer leading the way and scoring. So, good to see. We have a large versus small Dairyland matchup here.
Should be a very exciting game. Two high-powered offenses, actually. So.
Yeah.
Before we start here, we'll have the national anthem and starting lines momentarily. We have our booth number out there, so feel free to text in any questions, comments, answers, critiques. If either of us mispronounce the name, we're very sorry. If there are any away fans out there, if you would just mind texting us in and letting us know the correct pronunciation or any little tidbits you have for us are greatly appreciated. All these help for making better broadcast for you guys, so.
Please don't call us.
No.
It's really hard to hear anything up in here.
Taxi we prefer, so. Hopefully we'll have a good game, and yeah, we'll have the national anthem here momentarily.
I think it's going to be sung by Zach Thoreau, so I saw him making his way over.
All right.
And he looks
dressed
he's got,
up.
He's got a tie on, yeah, I know.
And jeans.
Welcome to the campus of Manila High School for tonight's game between the Cochrane-Fountain City Pirates and your Emmanuel Lutheran Lancers. Please stand and remove your hats for the singing of the national anthem.
Nice job there by three sophomores, Mark Brown Kepnar, Zach Thurl, and Jordan Kwong. That was actually really nice.
Yeah.
We'll have the starting lineups momentarily.
Thank you, Jordan. And off our starting lineup, so it's a clock and count, too. Freshman number one, Lexi Schmidt. Senior number three, Joe Heber. Sophomore number four, Riley Gable. Junior number 23, Corbin Lee. And senior number 31, Elizabeth Olson. The Pirates are coached by Randy Matt. And now for your Lancer. Senior number 12, Emily Hine. Freshman number 14, Lauren Sutton. Senior number 20, Joe Hannemeyer. Senior number 24, Becca Nauman. And junior number 42, Carl Meyer. The last is coach by Jimmy Kessler.
In case you didn't hear that, I'll repeat the starting lineups here. Number 1, Lexi Schmidtnecht. Number 3, Jill Hebert. Number 4, Riley Gable. Number 23, Kerrigan Liga. Number 31, Elizabeth Olson. And yeah, sorry.
That's and for the Lancers, we have number 12, Emily Hine. Number 14, Lauren Sodnick. Number 20, Johanna Meyer. Number 24, Becca Naumann. And number 42, Cara Meyer.
Jumping, we'll have Liga against Meyer. Tip won by the Lancers. Hine with the quick shot. Hine gets it to drop right away. Schmidt-Necht will set up the offense. Hebert up top. Swung over, and Schmidt-Necht won't go. Rebound down low. That shot won't go. And again, another rebound by Gable. A few quick offensive boards, and that shot will go down by Liga.
Lancer's got a box out there. Got some offensive rebounds.
And they're going to get a push called on, looks like it's going to be Hebert. Yes, that's her first team's first.
Full court pressure here by the Pirates. See how that works.
Lauren Sotnick will bring it up. Hine decides not to shoot the three. Swung all the way over. Hine with the drive. Naumann from the baseline. In and out. Rebound. Meyer. Meyer gets the foot back to go.
That was a good shot by Becca. Working, getting through the offense. Good shot. But good job by Becca cutting the middle, going for the board. Looks like they're in a 2-3. Lancers are.
Yep. Gable swings back up to Hebert. Tries to go down low. Schmidt-Necht and off her hand goes to the Lancers. Two-two-one trap. In trouble. Lancers trying to pass out of it. They get it up.
She's gonna have to cross.
They gotta go. They gotta cross. Hine for three. That's long. And that's gonna stay with White off of Gable. That's an interesting call. I know CFC, some CFC didn't like it, and
yeah.
I'm not too sure myself, but
yeah,
he was right there.
I thought Sotnick knocked it out.
Meyer for three. Meyer gets a three to go down.
She has a really good shot.
Schmidt-Necht. Pass back out to Hebert. Stolen by Hine. Hine all the way. Easy jump stop layup. And we're going to have a quick timeout by CFC.
This is looking really good right now.
Lancers coming off strong.
Good offense.
30 seconds.
Good job of working through the offense at least.
Yeah, they're this game, Lancers being a lot more patient.
Getting open shots.
They aren't forcing up that contested shot or driving in where it's not there. So.
Yeah,
bit necked. Swung over Gable. And nice pass down to Liga, and she puts it in.
That was a good driving dish.
Lancers break the press this time quite easily. Sotnik from the shoulder, won't go. Gonna stay here at the Lancers. Ooh. Off of Schmidt-Necht. And for the Lancers, we have number 10, Abby Nowen, number 14.
44.
44, sorry. I can't, it's hard to see. Caleb Bartles checking in for Cara Meyer and Becca Nauman.
Going really small here, 5 guards. Yeah. Which means Lancers are probably going to put some pressure on. Yep.
And shots long, but rebound by Nauman. That's Abby Nauman. On to Bartles. Bartles from top of the key. Won't go. Sotnik gets a rebound and says she stepped out. Goes to CFC.
Checking
in
for
Cochrane
Fountain, number 30, Gail Kamarski.
Yep, bringing the pressure.
Swung up to Gable. And CSC breaks it quick, so see what Lancers do here. This is McKenna Gable.
Oh, nice shot fake.
That was a good shot fake. Liga won't go. Rebound. Rebound put back by Kamrowski.
That's the one thing Lancers have been prone to is not boxing out. They haven't been very good at it. At getting good consistent boxing.
And got the travel.
Which is something they're especially going to have to do now when they don't have a lot of height in.
Yep. Swung over, swung inside. CFC doing a nice job moving the ball. Gable tries to get down. Will bounce off of White. Stays here. Checking in is number 15. This is Melanie Scratch. She played down on JV earlier today. Pass into Liga. Liga banks it in. CSC going on a small run here. Lancers break the press.
Oh, nice pass. Nice fake.
And no traveled. Yep.
That was a really good passing sequence there by the Lancers.
That was really good ball.
And it was a good shot fake, too, by Bartles. Just
got to keep that foot down. Yeah. Just one. And they get in. Swung back to Gable.
Ooh.
Gets out of it. Nice move. And no travel called there. On the ground and recovered by Sotnik. Pass all the way up to Bartles. Bartles gets the easy two to go. Scratch breaks the press. Stolen by Hine. And who are they going to get the ball on? Emily Hine.
Looks like she had
her. Wait.
Charge?
Yeah, going down. So they're calling it on Scratch.
Yeah, I was going to say, it looks like Hine before she had her ankle rolled on.
That's her first personal, team's second.
Oh, Pirates taking off the press. Carmeyer came in for Emily Hine there. She must be bleeding, I think. Yeah.
Miscommunication there. Bartles cannot save it. Out of bounds. Nice little ole pose there by Paul Sullivan. And they're going to get a holding call here.
On Nauman.
Is that on Abby Nauman's first personal, team's first? Stolen by Meyer. Meyer puts up the turnaround. Gets it to go.
She's made a few
and
shots.
Joe steals again. Bartles on the ground. No jump ball call. Bartles is hurt. Oh, nice pass down. Won't get there. Gable with the shot. Rebound by Meyer.
There are only three of them on defense there.
Get it up.
Good job.
Meyer attacking. Joe Meyer can't get it to go. That was good defense by the three Lancers that got back. Joe Meyer had to help clear the Bartles, who was hurt. Ibert passed down. Swung. Scratch for three. That's short. Rebound Liga. Pass down low. Back out. Swung
they
around.
They have some very good passing, the Pirates, too.
And that three is off by Hebert.
They're not necessarily making their shots, but they have some on-point passing.
They do. Kara Meyer with the rebound there.
Oh! Kara had Joe.
Misses that shot from the shoulder and poked out by Nauman. Will stay with CFC. Checking in is number four, Riley Gable, and number one, Lexi Schmidt.
And for the Lancers, number 24, Becky Nauman.
Becca Nauman come in for Joe Meyer.
Pirates break the press. Schmidt neck. Swung back up top. Scratch dribbles in. Nice dish.
That was a good pass.
And that is Kamrowski for two.
Kamrowski.
They have no one there to break it. Long pass. Ooh, got Takara.
Nice dish into Nauman. Nauman can't finish. Rebound Kamrowski.
Oh, two. Looks like she was going to reach there. I know that happens. You can see it with quite a few players. When they make a mistake or something, they try and be really aggressive to either make the big play or
that
eventually
shot by Kamrowski's off. Nice rebound by Becca Nauman, and they're going to have a push here. Looks like it's going to be on number 30, Kayla Kamrowski.
But on that, they're eventually going to try and make the play or get a foul, and usually ends up being the foul.
It's her first team, third.
Emily Hine coming in, and Joanna Meyer coming in for Lauren Sotnick and Kayla Bartles.
Oh, nice defense by Smitnack. Oof. And stolen right back by Meyer.
Didn't need that extra pass. Gotta get better spacing. Oh, there you go. Look.
Breaks it.
She gets. No, she's gotta take that.
Tries passing a little too late. Right good. There was Kamrowski.
Yeah, that was good. Getting back on defense. Good transition, D.
Schmidtneck pass. Now for three. Schmidtneck won't go. Rebound Meyer.
Oh!
Nice pass to Becca Nauman. Puts up the shot. Won't go. Gets her own rebound. Becca Nauman won't go again. This time rebound by Riley Gable. Slow it down wisely.
Oh, Becca's there right there. Nice. Good job by Becca. She saw it and hesitated for a second.
And Cara Meyer tries to pass it up to Abby Nauman. Stolen back by Kamrowski. And buzzer will sound. At the end of one, tight game. Lancers 13, Cochrane-Fountain City 10.
What's up with this?
Sorry about the scoreboard. Is it, I'm not sure what part of the scoreboard, if it is you just can't see it, or what, or you can make it bigger, Clay's making it bigger, say put it back in the corner maybe, let's see, yeah. That seems
yeah,
weird.
I don't know.
Because we don't want to take up too much of the screen.
So,
I don't think that'd be a good idea.
So, during that, some point during the first year, I received a few texts from a CFC fan, which is great. I love hearing from you guys. And they gave us a pronunciation.
Probably Liga.
Liga, yeah.
Well, I was going to say, because
he's been saying that, so I didn't know if I should be doing that or not, but that is what it is, so thank you. And Schmidtneck is the other one. And then number 15, Melanie Scraw. So thanks a lot for that. So, Appreciate hearing from you guys, home and away.
Or neither. What if we get any random people that just like stumble upon our videos?
Oh, yeah.
No clue what they're watching.
Except that they're just watching this.
They're watching basketball.
1.5 hour basketball game of some place they've never heard of.
Yeah.
Charlo will bring up the ball. Ooh. Gable drives. Liga drives, loses it, but gets it to Olsen. Charlo, that shot won't go. Gable gets the rebound. Liga passes it away and recovered by CFC.
Oh my goodness.
Through the hands of Riley Gable, goes to the Lancers.
Had a lot of errant passes here.
There's a lot going on in that little bit right there.
Yeah, we've had quite a few passes going wide lately. They're going to have to buckle down.
So the Pirates have kind of come out of their press. So they didn't start the clock again, so it should be at 7:25. Give me a green ball. Pass over to Nauman, and Beck and Nauman can't handle it. It goes back to CFC.
Yeah, right there again, you gotta catch it.
And everyone's having trouble catching the ball tonight. Even the ref couldn't hold on to it.
Oh,
and yeah, they got Charlo for a travel.
There have been quite the number of turnovers in this game by both teams.
Yeah. Gotta catch them all.
Could just be the first half. I don't know, maybe they're a bit rusty or. Ooh.
Pass over to Nauman.
Nice catch.
Oh, nice dish by Carl Meyer. Abby Nauman can't finish. Rebound Olsen. Charlo, another travel. That's good hustle by Abby Nauman. Kind of caused that travel there.
Yeah, they're not watching behind them when they're dribbling.
McKenna Gable comes in for Karen Charlo. Pass to Meyer. Puts up a shot baseline. That's a tough shot. Not a good
choice.
Yeah,
not a very... Especially when they didn't really work the offense. I mean, you got to take your time on that.
And tipped by Hines. Stolen by Abby Nauman. Splits a D. Goes all the way. Won't go. And they're going to get over the back call on Emily Hine.
Yeah, I think Nauman was kind of...
Is that her first?
Yeah.
Team second.
Third. Oh, I missed a foul in there. I'll figure it out when I count up. Yeah, I'll figure it out.
And again, the clock is off, so little mishaps here. Are they going to let the sub? Yep, they'll let the sub come in. Lexi Schmidt-Neck comes in.
Those refs are really alert about that.
Yeah, they are. I'm kind of surprised. Liga drives baseline. And they say out of bounds. Goes back to the Lancers. Pirates back in their press. Broken by the Lancers. Nice dribble move there. Carl Meyer gets the kid to go. Schmidt-Neck brings it up.
Oh,
nice back pass.
That was really good.
No one watching weak side. She saw it right there.
That was beautiful.
Meyer dribbles through it. Pass to Carl Meyer. Carl Meyer finishes at the basket. And not looking good here, Olsen. Elizabeth Olsen is down grabbing her ankle.
I didn't see if she just landed on it or did she land on someone
else's
ankle.
I didn't see what
happened
either.
I missed that.
She looks in a lot of pain.
I wish we had the booth to play. I don't know.
For some reason, we do not have a trainer here tonight.
Yeah.
We do have Prof. Lalo.
He's seen it all.
He has seen it all. He's been through a lot.
I think Prof. Krantz went back to get ice just to be safe.
Well, it's probably... It could be just a twist. It could be a sprain. She's in a lot of pain. That is...
I don't know much about foot injuries.
Not looking good.
I mean, there's like Achilles tendon. I don't know.
No, that's not Achilles.
How you do that.
She is holding more of kind of up top, not really in the back. Hey, we had a guy in a nurse uniform down there.
Guy in scrubs.
Yeah. And she gets up, able to hop off with the help of her coach.
Oh, yeah, I was going to say, I know we have a few people.
Yeah.
I don't know if they're here or not, but that are nurses.
Yep.
I don't know. I mean, I know they're different nurses for different things.
We'll try to get an update for you guys and let her know what you know how she's doing later on in the game. Probably about halftime, we'll try to figure something out. He did get ice, so they'll probably put ice on it. Schmidt neck brings it up. Schmidt neck, nice drive baseline. Dish, good movement by Pirates. And Gable gets her own rebound, but she will travel. Good also, but it's a little too much. Lance just passed through it. Oh, nice pass to Meyer. A little behind her. She gets it. Her shot will not go in and out. Schmidtneck brings it up the court. Passing to Liga, and her shot won't go straight up. Meyer with the rebound, and Lancers recover. Pass down to Beckenauer, can't handle it. Ooh,
yeah,
almost another ankle injury. Beckenauer kind of landed on Kamrowski's ankle. That's her first personal, team's third. Nice shot fake and dribble in by Gable. Gets her own rebound and puts it back up. And also by Riley Gable. One defense here by the CFC. Emily Hine, wide open three, and she hits it. Just can't leave it wide open. Gable looking to get inside. Set passes out. And that drive is off. Rebound by Liga.
CFC has had quite the number of offensive rebounds. I'm not sure how many, but they have a lot.
Ball stolen by Meyer. Pass up to Sotnik. Hine dribbles baseline. Puts up the shot. Won't go. Rebound Schmidtneck.
There's no one there for the Lancers to even rebound.
2-on-3 here. Wisely passes it out. Or to McKenna Gable.
Thought
about three, won't take it. Swung down Kamrowski, and she lays it in. Kayla Kamrowski.
Pirates have been doing a pretty good job pressing against the zone, find the spots, and then another good shot fake and drive.
We have a full timeout by CFC.
Bartles It's going to come in for Nauman. Becca Nauman.
Still a tight game here. I mean, only a 4-point difference. Lancers up 20-16. 3 minutes left here in the second. Both teams are actually doing a really good job. CFC really getting off of those after those offensive boards. Just can't finish their shots. And then their turnovers. Both teams had quite a few turnovers tonight.
Yeah, there's been a lot of steals. Well, I mean, that's bound to happen when both teams have been pressing for quite a bit and playing zone, but I think both teams just kind of slow down, play their game. I don't think either team is really more of a fast-paced team. If anything, Lancers, so CFC, it looks like they like to set up their offense because they've been doing a good job of passing against the zone and making plays from there. So we'll see maybe if they can keep the pace slower. I don't know, but they do press. It looks like they're coming out in a 1-3-1 right now. I don't know if we've seen this from CFC yet today.
Sotnik brings the ball up the court. Pass to Sotnik. Sotnik saves it. Gets over to Bartles. Good hustle. And nice tip by Schmidtneck. But saves here at the Lancers. So kind of more of a lax 1-3-1 here coming out of the break. They aren't really trapping in the corner. Sotnik will set up the offense. Hine, quick three in the corner. Won't go. Rebound, Schmidtneck. Gable, and they'll get a foul called here. Foul is on Emily Hine. That's her second, team's fourth. Actually, not a lot of fouls this game. There's only been a total of 7 fouls for both teams.
Yeah, okay, they did miscount before.
Okay.
In their timeout assessment.
That's Gable with the long three. That's off. Rebound, Kamrowski. Kamrowski gets it in.
Kamrowski.
No one's boxing out, and Pirates are taking advantage of it. So Lauren to Meyer, Joe Meyer. Caro swung over.
They're really coming out on Emily and Joe hard.
Joe Meyer gets the hook. That's one thing about Joe Meyer. She plays the guard, but she can also work as a post.
Yeah.
Shot
she,
by
she,
off.
She does a good job with her post moves. Let's see if Emily can see Lauren. Oh, didn't get turned in.
Barrows poked away by Charlotte. Pass up to Kamrowski.
Oh.
Loses it. Stolen by Joe Meyer. And Doc Siddle will call timeout. And Abby Nauman will check into the game. 30-second timeout by Emmanuel.
So let's see. He got Abby Nauman into the game for Kara Meyer.
I want to apologize real quick if you hear me sniffling. Just getting over a head cold, so kind of still lingering here. Thankfully, the influenza really hasn't hit too hard here as it has in some places in the U.S. I mean, once it does, it can spread like wildfire inside a dormitory. We'll see. Hopefully not. Back to the game here. Sotnik brings the ball up. Sotnik with the deep two. That's off. Both teams have it. And they call it travel. That is really quick.
Yeah. I don't know. I thought girls on both teams had it, so I thought I was going to call it jump.
Yeah. I really don't agree with that. Pass to Hine, back out to Sotnik. Nice dribble move by Joe. Can't get the floater to go. Rebound Sotnik. Forty seconds left.
Oh, wait. Ooh. Say if Emily would have rotated down a little quicker, they might have had her. Same there with Becca.
Yeah, well, they had a little gap.
She had Emily back to her.
Shot fake stolen by Schmidneck. Schmidneck will go all the way against Sotnik. Won't go. No foul called there. Blocked by Liga. And they got travel. Wow.
I thought that was a block.
I did too. I'm going to get a little explanation here. Wow. 15 seconds here. That's a surprising call. I don't know how much I agree with that one either.
Yeah.
Warrior drives baseline, pass to Nauman. That one's blocked. 6 seconds left. See if they notice. Schmidneck passes up. Easy layup.
Oh!
And that goes in at the buzzer. Charlo.
Yeah, and that block. I thought it got blocked in the
score at halftime, 22-20 in favor of the Lancers.
That was a very good job of executing it, getting it all the way down. And
yeah, caught the Lancers off guard. All three of them were up here trying to get the ball yet, and they just passed right over them. So good awareness.
So yeah, at halftime, I don't really have the rebounds because I kind of got lost in that. But for the Lancers, leading scorers, Emily Hine and Johanna Meyer have a 7 apiece. Kara Meyer has 6, and Kayla Bartles has 2. Hines only one in foul trouble with 2, and then Nauman and both the Naumans, Beck and Abby, have 1 apiece.
For Cochrane-Fountain City, Lexi Schmidneck has 2. Jill Hebert has 1 foul. Riley Gable has 2 points. Karen Charlot just had that 2 at the buzzer beater. Kerrigan Liga had 6. Those came early, and she really has not scored since. So,
yeah.
Lancers did a good job of kind of keeping her out.
Or she could have just been missing her shots.
Big one
too.
Here. Kayla Kamrowski has 8 points and 1 foul. And Scraw has 1 foul.
Not much is going on campus. I don't know if you guys have any questions or anything, just ask us.
Yeah, if you have any questions or anything, comments, send us a text. We'll have something to talk about during halftime.
Especially halftime, yeah. Halftime can kind of drag on.
Or that, or you can use this halftime to refresh your popcorn and get a drink.
Refresh.
Movie theater quality, that's what we're going for.
I don't know about you, I'm almost falling asleep up here.
That's why we have the fan on. Kind of get some air blowing.
True. Wow.
I don't know, did the JV game earlier today, so I've been up here since 6 o'clock.
Ooh, here's a good one. Our Super Bowl thoughts. Thank you, Mr. Chaser.
Not
Uncle
watching
Matt.
It.
I'm. You gotta watch it.
I might watch some of it, but I.
Watching it for the ads.
Who? Oh.
Okay.
Wait. It says who's going to.
So many texts.
Cause that's hard. Cause I mean I'm torn. I want the Patriots to win. Cause for me it's tough to root for the Seahawks. Not that I'm against Russell Wilson winning one. I mean, I love Russell Wilson.
He's already won.
And I mean, Seattle's already proven that they have a very respectable defense. And on that, but I mean, I think it's going to be a lot harder for them this year because they don't have Golden Tate. And they're more of a one-dimensional team. And I know you can say Russell Wilson, oh, he had that play at the end, but he does not have the best receivers in the world.
And
not even close.
This isn't just because they beat the Packers, but I am going for the Patriots. I do want them to kind of whoop up on them. But
get Brady his last Super Bowl win?
I just
yeah,
feel like,
there's that whole deflate gate.
Yeah,
I don't know.
I'm not getting into that.
I don't know what you guys think. Yeah. I mean, it's completely hypothetical. I mean, no one's ever gonna know because Brady and Belichick did do it. They're definitely not gonna say anything until like they're retired. Especially if they win the Super Bowl, I wouldn't be surprised. For anyone to say anything, unless it's like some ball boy would like come out and say it, and then Tom Brady would hate him for the rest of his life. And
see, I don't like hearing that people saying Russell Wilson's an elite quarterback.
He's a good quarterback.
He's a good one, but he's not in that top tier.
Even though he's won a Super Bowl, I mean,
look at all the help he had.
He does have a good defense. I mean, you can argue that, but you also need the numbers there, and he really hasn't had.
No. I mean, if you did watch a Packer game, a bunch of his one of his interceptions, he just totally underthrew the guy.
Yeah.
He really does not have a deep ball. He kind of just lofts it up there and hopes for the best.
Brett Favre?
Yeah, kind of like Brett Favre.
Except he actually did have a deep ball.
He was known as a gunslinger, so he could do that.
I know.
But.
Yeah. So, I do want the Pats to win though.
Yep.
I mean.
Even though I can't stand them, I
like Tom Brady. I like Tom Brady. And the rest of the. rest of the guys. You got. Part of you has to love Belichick. I mean, the hoodie,
not after that.
He just seems like he just seems like a grumpy old guy, and
he does.
I don't know. Part of me just, I don't know.
I don't like him.
I don't know why. I just like Bill Belichick.
He is a good coach. I'll give him that. But yeah. That's about it. That's all I'll give.
So, yeah. Just as long as I'm not a big fan of whenever it's like, oh, I'm watching it for the ads. It's like, then why are you even watching the game? You can go online the next day and find out which ads were good and which were not.
Yep.
Why are you going to sit there?
Well, there was a big controversy of one ad.
They do it for the food, too, and the party.
Yes, the food.
That's probably it.
That's the best part.
They just show up at someone's house and like, I'm just watching for the commercials, secretly, like, and the food, and just being with people. Kay.
Well, if you just take the first two things, it seem kind of like a jerk. But.
Yeah, it could be. That's just
in my opinion.
I can't exactly say that. I doubt a lot of people actually do that.
Oh, no. I'm not saying people are doing that, but just like, if you came to my house and you did that, I wouldn't appreciate it.
Looking for just the because that is a classic response, though, by people who say they're disinterested. But, yeah. I mean, I can't do that. I always, like, I'll watch bowl games and I'll be like, you know what, I'm just going to watch this game. I'm not going to root for anyone. I'm just going to watch the football game. And then halfway through, I'm like, I really want this team to win.
Yeah, if it's a bowl game like that and I don't really have a big interest in either team, then I will almost always root for the underdog.
I mean,
did anyone see Houston beat Pittsburgh?
I watched part of it. I heard about it though.
Like 30 some points in the fourth quarter alone. Two onside kicks recovered.
It was like
back to back.
It was 28 in 7 minutes.
Yeah.
I think it was.
It was insane. Those are the games I love watching. But that's a good question. Thank you,
yep.
Mr. Shazer.
So yeah. I took up most of it.
So my mom texted and she says she doesn't want either to win. She knows like either of them all kinda has to be a victor in the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
It could be
like Batman, where Bane shows up.
You can't have a tie.
Can't have a tie. I'll split the trophy down the middle.
It won't be a tie.
You get half, you get half. You guys, instead of rings, they get bracelets. And they have, like, a budget on them. Like, whatever they usually spend, cut that in half.
Yep.
Or instead of not bracelets, they get, like, keychains. They'll have
there
it on their lanyard coming in the air.
Like,
I was co-champion with 105 other guys. Not to mention staff and faculty.
Would be 104. 52-man roster.
53.
Well, that'd be 106.
Well, yourself. 105 other guys.
I guess. Good point. Really? I thought it was always 52-man roster.
I think it's 53. I could be wrong. Someone correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure it's 53.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not going to bother to look it up.
I'm thinking back, like, to my Madden days in 2007. You can only have 52 guys, so they probably...
It could be. I don't know. Also, I have to give a shout-out to... I know a lot of you don't follow the NBA, but I have to give a shout-out to Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Oh, jeez.
He's going to be in the dunk contest. He is probably the most exciting thing since the iPhone came out. I mean, he is it all. He's a 6'11 Greek freak who's insanely good at basketball and can, like, do a layup while picking up his dribble from the three-point line. And
right.
So I had to say that. I couldn't contain that. He's easily my favorite basketball player. And I challenge anyone to say they're a bigger fan than I am, be honest.
Yeah, I'm not really one that follows the NBA, so.
Yeah, it's 53.
Be Lancers ball coming out of the break here. Lauren Sotnick will bring it up.
1-3-1 again here for CFC. Must have thought it was working pretty well, so they come back out in it.
Hine, wide open three, hits it again. It's two wide open threes for Hine.
That's a good way to start a half. That's how they started the last half, too. Except for, it was a two, but it was close.
Yeah. Gable, long two, that rims out. Rebound, Joe Meyer.
Ooh.
And we'll get a jump ball. Goes to CFC. Gable getting in there. Riley Gable.
Sotnick, I'm not sure she was hurt on that. I think she is a little bit.
Yeah, she looks a little bit in pain.
Still coming back in that 2-3.
Passing to Gable. Ooh. Down to Liga. And Liga gets a go down.
Liga.
Her first point since the first.
Ooh.
Oh, Joe Meyer tried to save it, but Kanaman wasn't ready.
It's a good job of getting the save, but...
Nice dish to Liga. Good also by Carl Meyer.
Good job by Beckenhauen getting on the floor for that one. Almost had it.
That's a long two by Schmidtneck. That's off. Rebound, Joe Meyer.
Oh!
Oh, nice steal.
That
Gable.
Was a pretty good steal.
Pass into Nauman, doesn't look for a shot. You have it down there, look for that.
A lot of coaches will get on you if you mess up that play. But if you make that play, it is like the greatest feeling in the world.
Yep.
One of them, I should say.
Hine hits another three. Hine's feeling it early tonight. Gable puts up the shot, that's short. Rebound Joe Meyer. Hi, another
three.
Another
one?
No, that's off.
Good job by
good.
Becca.
Box out by Becca Nauman. Boxer inside, got the long rebound. Swung into Gable again, over to McKenna Gable.
They have some very good ball movements.
And one. They got the late foul on Carmine.
They have some very good ball movements.
They do.
That was really nice.
I think that's Caro's first, isn't it?
Yes,
it is. That's her first team's first. Kayla Kamrowski will come in for Kerrigan Liga. That one's off, rebound by Hine.
Ooh, another steal by
Gableson from behind. Steals it.
Gable's doing a good job defensively. She's
a Liga got hit in the jaw. That's why she came out. She's a little hurt. Stolen by Joe Meyer. Hine jump stop.
She thought about that three and she gets it now.
Oh, she'll take this one. That's short. Rebound by Hebert.
Ooh. She would have pushed that. She maybe could have had a chance at that.
Dish down.
This is really good
nice
passing.
Dish to Kamrowski. That's blocked. Gonna be off of the Pirates. Goes down.
CSC may be down, but they have had some very good passing.
Abby Nauman and Caleb Bartles are checking in for Becca Nauman and Carl Meyer. Megan Winger comes in for CFC, as well as Scraw. Sonic brings it up. Kick out to Meyer. Oh, nice dish to Sotnik. Sotnik can't get it to go. Rebound, Kamrowski stolen by Meyer.
Oh,
and that out by Scraw. Again, a lot happened in that little bit. Hit Emily Hine in the corner for three. Hine can't to go. Rebound, Kamrowski.
Oh, my. Abby Nauman almost had that.
Scraw driven all the way down.
She had a rotate. Oh, she should have.
Stolen by Sotnik. Pass up to Nauman and no. Yep, travel. I was wondering if they're going to catch that.
Yeah, that was a tricky situation. She had Hine and Nauman like just in front of her, but not entirely much so. And tough decision by the time she passed it. I mean, they would
Gable
be able to
bring it up.
Skip pass, corner.
Swung over, that's a three. And that three is good by Winger.
Feeling good for calling that.
Sotna can't get it in the post, stolen. CFC going on their own little run.
Splitting the double team.
Scraw will set it up. Back to the corner. Another three. That one's off. Rebound Sotnik. And it's stolen. Out of bounds off White. Goes to CSC. Jill Hebert comes in. And Liga comes in for the CSC.
Carmeyer came in for Lauren Sotnik. Oh, Mr. Lau does the commentating by the scorebook. He's the one that's calling out all the shots. Shot here.
Ooh. That's off. Rebound, Joe Meyer. Try again to Meyer. Not there. And jump ball. Stays here at the Lancers. Meyer gets it in. Hine will drive all the way down. Blocked out. Stays here. Joe Meyer gets it to Carmeyer. Carmeyer short. Rebound by Gable.
Bet that's the first time that's been said.
So back to Gable, and stolen by Joe Meyer.
Oh, she had Kara. Oh, she did not see her. She had Kara just sitting there in the post.
Has her again, but And Meyer hits from the top of the key.
Yeah, I think Coach CSU on a moving screen there. One of the two.
Stolen by Bartles. Pass to Nauman. That's off. Rebound Bartles. And they're going to get a reach in. It's going to stay here. Let's see.
Thank you, Eunice and Doc.
Looks like they're going to be shooting two.
Well, thank you, Eunice and Doc Albrecht, for watching us. From Arizona.
Spurs personal.
From Arizona.
Oh, sorry.
Hello to you.
Caleb Bartles will be shooting. CSC not liking that they called in the shooting motion. Bartles hits the first free throw. Schmidt Neck comes in for McKenna Gable. Misses her second one, and rebound by Hebert. Scraw going all the way down. That shot won't go. Stay 0 CFC. Becca Nauman comes in for Joanna Meyer. Scraw will set it up. Or the winger. Swung all the way over. Nice pass. Stolen by Nauman, but stolen right back.
Might need to do some pass fakes in there. I mean, CC's usually done a good job passing, but they're kind of becoming predictable in their passes. I mean, they swing it around a lot.
And Emily Hyde dribbles up, hits a three.
Oh, we split the double team.
Pass down the Liga. Won't go. Rebound. Back to Nauman.
She wanted a foul on that play.
I think they would have, but I think she's straight up. That's why they didn't call it. Bartles, wide open shot. Baseline. That one will fall. Lancers on a small run here. 50 seconds in the third.
They get better spacing. Oh.
Ooh. Liga. Down the post, kicks it back. Good dribble, goes down, and Carl Meyer will get the rebound. 30 seconds, let's see what the Lancers do with the take one shot. Moving the ball. Carl Meyer, shoulder, won't go. Becca Nauman gets the rebound, 8 seconds left.
Oh.
Hey, Kayla down the post, tries to go to Abby Nauman.
She has to shoot soon.
Tries passing out. Oh. And the timer will end in the third quarter.
Bit of a
score, Lancers 38, CFC 29. Riley Gable will check into the game for CFC.
You have to see how this fourth quarter goes. Lancers went on a bit of a run there, got a 9-point lead, but I mean, CC's not out of it. I mean, games can change very quickly, especially when they're playing a pressure-type defense. I mean, you can always
coming right out of the break there, CFC went on their own little, like, 6-point run, I think, so they're definitely capable of it. Both teams need to slow it down and make sure they take good shots, and they really work their offense, open shots. So.
And also, prof wrote about that hurt. Giannis is going to stay on the Bucks for a long time.
We'll see.
he literally said, he's like, there's no, he's like, I can't remember, it was him or Jabari, one of them two. It's like, I'm not going to leave until I bring a championship to Milwaukee. Which, I mean, means he's never going to leave.
That's going to last for like 2, maybe 3 years, and then.
No, he's going to stay. He loves Milwaukee.
Whoops, I meant I'll stay for a little while, but it's time to move.
No, he's going to stay, and it's going to be beautiful.
Out of respect, I'll say I hope he stays for you.
Yes. Still in this 2-3.
That shot by Schmidtmeck is off. Almost stolen there. Passed out of it. CSC really aggressive. Leaves Carmeier open. Rebound Sotnick puts up the shot. Won't go. And that will stay here at the Lancers. Awesome CSC.
It's pretty interesting to Meyer. She used her left hand on that shot. Carmeier. That was kind of a jump shot, too. I mean,
I know there are a few girls who can shoot with their left hand. Joe Meyer for three. That won't go.
Yeah, she's a little off balance on the shot there. Ooh.
And it'll go down. Almost looked like the guy on the baseline was going to signal white, but the guy on the far side, ref on the far side, signaled black first, so they went with black. But get into Gable. Gable wasn't looking, but ends up with it.
Nice skip pass.
Nice dribble fake and scratch. Schmidtmeck gets it to go in. Back and out. Nice pass into Carmeier. Carmeier, easy layup.
Good job there. Getting it inside. Man.
Pass down to Liga. And travel. They'll go the other way. Sotnick barely gets in to Becca.
She really likes those, not backdoor passes, but.
Nice poke by Lauren Sotnick. Gets up to Hine. Hine passes over to Myers. And off of Gable stays with the Lancers.
Yep. Yeah, Gable tried to save and just slipped. They're really getting those inbounds in quickly. Yeah, I mean, to the players.
Meyer drives, and she'll draw the foul.
I mean, I don't know if it's just me, but I feel like they're doing it really quick.
Yeah, they are.
Man. Maybe the refs have somewhere to be afterwards.
Falls number 23, Kerrigan Light, Liga. It's her first. Joe Meyer makes the first one. Missed the second one. Rebound Carmeier. Puts it up. Won't go. Rebound Gable. McKenna Gable will bring it up. Loses control. And double dribble. Go back to the Lancers. Sotnick brings it up.
Oh.
Loses control of it. Stolen. Up to Riley Gable.
Oh!
And blocked from behind by Hine. And they'll get a jump ball. Goes back to the Lancers.
I just assumed it was going to be a foul. I didn't really check, but Hine got all ball there. Good chase down defense. Good hustle play.
I'm kind of surprised they didn't call foul. Normally they would on that.
Yeah, usually, and I mean, being a ref is very hard, so a lot of times they'll just see. If it's usually going to be a foul, they'll call it a foul.
Yep.
Because, I mean,
Emily in trouble, gets knocked out by Schmidtmeck.
I mean, if you're not sure what it is, might as well call it what it usually is.
Yep.
And usually they'll call that a foul. Or at least at high school, because, I mean, not to be mean, but high school kids, they're not college athletes or pro athletes.
Hines miss, Beckenauman with the rebound, block. And Beckenauman gets the rebound off of Joe Myers' shot and puts it in.
Oh.
Riley Gable, pass to Liga, blocked by Joe Meyer. Wow.
She's got Sotnick.
Sotnick won't go, rebound Carmeier.
They get her over the back.
No, they got a push on black.
Ooh. I didn't see.
23.
I think that was off ball.
Yeah, Liga. That was definitely off ball because she is still up here. She wasn't down there.
It was on hybrid, though. Or no, oh, it was on Liga?
Yeah.
Oh, it was.
Kamrowski checked in. And full timeout by the Lancers.
Okay, I thought it was.
That must have been off ball because she wasn't down low where the rebound was.
I thought if anything, it was maybe
over
the back on Meyer.
Yep.
That's the only thing I could have thought so.
Lancers clinging to a 12-point lead here. 5 minutes left in the fourth.
Seem to be very in control. I mean, they've had 5 fouls this game. That
five
is
fouls.
A very impressive stat. Where is that? Not many fouls being called this game.
And,
either. I mean, CFC
CSE only has 6. So neither team would have reached a bonus yet.
Yeah.
Even if it was in one half.
Yeah.
So, yeah, they're... Even in the JV game, too, they're letting them go pretty much all game.
Yeah. Well, and it's not even just letting them go, but, I mean, it's a fairly clean game. I mean, they did let some, but, I mean, it was also a fairly clean game being played, which is always good to see. I mean, it's not always exciting when you got people fouling all over the place.
Yeah, it makes the game drag on for a while. So
you all know when you're watching a game before... Your game on TV, but the other team keeps fouling even though you know they have no chance, and
yep.
It just annoys you. Cara Meyer,
shoots a three. She can shoot out there. Nice save by Cara Meyer.
Not too bad a shot. I would have liked to see them maybe set up the offense more instead of shooting right away off the inbounds pass, but not too bad a shot.
And stolen by Riley Gable. She's had quite a few steals this game.
Yeah, good job defensively.
Schmidtneck. Won't go. Rebound by Hine. Needs to pass out of it.
Oh, they're both in the same. Oh, okay.
Meyer dribbles out of it. Hine will shoot the quick three. Won't go. Rebound. Sotnik will
bunch
put it up.
There
won't go. And it'll go to the Pirates. Swung over to Riley Gable. Schmidtneck long two. And she hits it. Nice shot by Schmidtneck.
Oh, again.
Nice steal. Wow.
She's got quick hands. I mean.
She does.
She got that on a crossover. That is not easy to do.
Good shot fake. Off and rebound by Schmidtneck. Kamrowski puts it in. 8-point game. And now they got her for the reach. Trying to go around.
Is that her
That's
first?
Her first. Kale Bartles and Abby Nauman are coming in for Lauren Sotnik and Becca Nauman. And gets it to Bartles.
Oh, my.
Nice steal by McKenna Gable.
She just grabbed it. Wow. Skip pass.
Swung around. And that shot is short. Rebound McKenna Gable. And they'll get a push. I'm guessing that's going to be on Abby Nauman. Nope, that's going to be on Kale Bartles.
Her first.
Her first. Team's fifth.
Second.
Second, sorry, I was looking that away. Charlot, dish down to Gable, drives baseline, puts up, won't go.
Carr's been doing a good job of going straight up this game.
No jump ball called, and Kamrowski gets it to go.
Although that last one, if she would have made contact, I think would have been a foul.
6-point game. Jump by, and they're going to get a push on Joe Meyer.
That's Schmidtneck, her
good
first.
Hustle.
CFC's
making a run here.
Yep. I almost said back in it, but they've always been in it. They haven't been out of it yet. You gotta look. Ooh.
Lance is getting burned inside right now.
Yeah.
I mean. Good anticipation by Carl Meyer. Knocked that one away.
CSC doing a good job. I mean, they can't exactly afford to be patient, but they've been doing a good job of trying to be patient while also trying to speed up the pace.
Riley Gable comes in for Karen Charlot. Lauren Sotnick and Becca Nauman come back in for Caleb Bartles and Abby Nauman.
Lauren Sotnick. And 24, Becca Nauman.
Stolen by Sotnick. Nice steal. See what she does. Puts up the layup and Sotnick gets a contested layup to go. Back up to 8. That will be a 2. And rebound Gable.
Nice pass. Ooh.
And
she kept the pivot foot.
Wow. Gable with the quick shot. And that's Riley Gable. Timeout CFC.
I don't know.
2 minutes left. 6-point game.
That was Cameron. I don't know how she kept that pivot foot. But that was.
That was insane.
It's quite the balancing act there. So here you have it. 6-point ball game.
6-point game. A lot of time left, so it's going to come down right to the wire.
Yeah, we'll see. I mean, we could be in one of these foul situations at the end. Bunch of fouling going on. I'll see. They're looking at our free throw chart.
So just by,
so they get to see all my 20s out of 50. I haven't done that, actually.
I hope not.
Probably like, we do better than that. Right, and we're back.
It'll be white Lancer. Ball, Lancer ball going
I'm
down.
I'm surprised Pirates are taking off the press. I feel like they'd want it. Unless you're trying to half-court trap, which they kind of have been.
Probably.
Yeah, they've got Gable kind of scooting up.
Pass right away.
Oh.
Oh, kind of heard a slap there, but.
Yeah, I got hands on it. Well, that was.
Or was that on ball?
I think that was on ball. She got her hands on it again. I don't know how. Oh, yeah, that might have been a foul.
Oh, nice back door.
Oh! Oh!
They're going to get a foul.
That was a Jota quick foul.
Wow, she went down hard. Falls on McKenna Gable. That's her second, team's fifth.
At first that looked clean, but she did get some arm on that. I almost thought it was all ball. That would have been quite the block if it was all ball.
Mm-hmm. Can't get her first one to go, goes all the way around. Need to hit this one. I'm thinking that Lancer's going to go back to a man-to-man. Gets the second one to go. Going back half court, see what they do here. No, 1-3-1? Nope. I don't know what they're in. Oh, are they in their diamond formation? Yeah, reach on Sotnick there.
Yeah.
Gonna go underneath.
I mean, they do have some fouls to give, so it wasn't exactly
it's
too bad a foul.
Fourth personal.
I mean, not exactly a smart one. I mean, if this were college NBA, it would be dumb because it would reset the shot clock, but. Ooh.
Pass into the Liga, rebound Meyer, and they're gonna get Kamrowski with the foul. That's her second.
Next
team six, so next one is bonus.
Yep.
Probably didn't want that foul right then and there. Probably wanted to save that. Lancer's slowing it up.
Ooh.
Joe Meyer will shoot the three. Joe Meyer hits from three. 10-point game, 1 minute left in the game.
That was a big shot. That was a risky shot. I mean, if she misses that,
You don't exactly usually want to take a shot that quickly.
And they got traveled. Good tip by Cara Meyer there. Under a minute to go, they're going to bring out the press. They got to get down court. You aren't going to break the press just by passing back and forth side to side.
Yeah.
Got to get some cutting action.
Or someone just make a move dribbling, and I guess you can either hope for the best, or, I mean, if they're a good dribbler, they should be able to make it.
If nothing else, use your height, get Carr to go down court a little bit and kind of throw one over the top.
Or cut up to the middle.
Yeah.
Middle's always a good spot, so you can go everywhere from the middle.
And it's the hardest to cover.
Yeah, because they can go everywhere.
Yep.
Well, I mean, once if she's across half court, she can go back, but...
Forty-nine seconds left, 10-point game. Get into Joe Meyer, and they'll get a reach in on Hebert. That's her second, and Joe Meyer will be shooting 1-1. Karen Charlot will be checking in for CFC. She'll come in for Hebert. Misses it. Rebound Meyer. Knocked out. Wow.
I thought that was all ball.
I do not agree. Okay, I think that's why, because she came down with her arm.
And then after a ball, it got arm? Or
what?
After a ball, it got arm? Or
yeah, that's the only reason I can think of them calling that foul. She misses it. Wait.
I guess they must have had a shooting motion.
But, the only reason I could think is because her arm is coming down. Hits the second one. 11-point game, 45 left. Shot by Liga, won't go. Give me off of Charlot and goes to the Lancers. 37 left.
Oh,
bomb it down, stolen here by Gable. Shot, and that shot by Schmidtneck is good. Is it still 11-point game?
Ooh,
there we go. 9-point game.
Okay, they said their foes online. Good job there making sure that, whether if it was on the line or not, but,
Oh, yeah, she is within, though. That is a two. But,
I couldn't tell from here.
Yeah. That's a good shot, though. I get a quick steal and right back in. I mean, it's only a 7-point game, then three possession, I guess, but.
Don't really want to go for that baseball pass again, I think. You can help it. Oh, miscommunication there. Oh, and yep, that will be out.
Oh, my bad. Mic was off. So that stole my Liga and fall on Sotnik. Gable needs to put up a shot. Won't go. Rebound Gable. Schmidtneck for three. That was good.
Another timeout.
6-point game. 13 seconds left.
You think they can do it, Clay? Clay was asking for the dagger around 50 seconds. I think he may have been right there, but I don't know.
Not quite here.
Think
well,
they,
not
think
yet.
Think they still got it? No? Wait, yeah? Wait, so you think they still got a chance?
I think they still have a chance.
To win or tie?
I got my dagger in still.
You still got the dagger in. He still thinks that was the dagger. He still thinks it's a done deal. I mean, it's going to be very tough, I think.
Why? Get two threes off in 13 seconds?
Yeah, but I mean...
Without allowing the Lancers to score on free throws?
Yes. And if they do, then you have to get a third one. Yeah, or even a fourth one, depending on how many free throws they make. So, I mean, you foul
exactly.
once, make two, foul twice.
That's why I'm just leaving it in.
I'm
going to keep
doing
this.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. It's going to be very hard. They're going to have to get steal an inbounds pass in order to...
Oh, definitely, but I still think that there's still that chance.
They need more communication on their inbounds passing, too.
And it'll go down.
That was close.
That one's from Washington. Agree with Clay.
They have better communication, though, when they're bringing the ball in.
And they're getting reach and foul on Charlotte. It's her first. Team's ninth. Now,
how am I crazy?
We have different opinions.
Now I believe that.
We have some people thinking that Clay's right with the dagger. Some people thinking. Oh.
Wait, what?
I know.
What? Clay's.
This is a first one, and yep, over the back call.
Yep.
It's gonna go.
Oh, good point. We are not the Packers. Yeah, I think Clay had it correctly. Wayne Larrabee set the dagger at 50 seconds. Said CFC was done then.
Carmeier was called for the over the back.
And I think it's gonna be a bit hard now.
Yep.
Especially with that play.
And that should do it here. 6 seconds left. For some reason, Dax said it'll call timeout.
Clay did call it. I think he just wants to make sure we get the inbound pass in and nothing more than... I mean, just wants to make sure that they actually get the inbound pass in. They've had some bad communication. I mean, there's the deep ball to Joe that went astray, and then Emily stopped her cut. It's going to do a V cut, but Becca threw it ahead. I think just this time just wants to make sure they're all on the same page. We might be crazy. We were just trying to make sure that we had every possibility in there.
I mean, I definitely
we didn't want to rule anything out. We didn't want to we didn't want to be like the band is on the field, guys. We don't want to be them. It is our job to make sure that every possible outcome has been accounted for and will be accounted for.
And knocked out, we'll say it to the Lancers. 5 seconds.
That did at least knock us like a second off.
Come on.
Get it to her. And it'll go to black. So CSC will have the last second shot here.
That's right.
Pretty sure this is game. Just deciding what the final score will be. Schmidneck for three. Won't go. Final score. Emmanuel 50, CFC 44. That was a really good game by both teams. Hard fought to the bitter end.
So we got scoring. I didn't really get rebounds all this game. Sorry about that. Emily Hine had 16, two fouls. Lauren Sotnick, 2 points, two fouls. Johanna Meyer, 14 and a foul. Becca Nauman, 4 and a foul. Cara Meyer, 9 and 1 foul. And Kayla Burrows with 5 and a foul.
All right, for CFC, Lexi Schmidneck had 11, McKenna Gable had 2, Riley Gable had 6, but she also had quite a few steals. I didn't keep track of that, but she had some nice plays out there. Karen Charloa, 2, Kerrigan Liga had 8, Kayla Kamrowski had 12, and Megan Winger had 3.
All right. All right.
And no free throw shot by CFC tonight.
Like at all or just none made?
At all.
We have none. Oh, man.
Oh, well, none made. I don't know if there hasn't been any at all. But
I don't remember many,
there,
though.
There would have only been one or two because there were not many.
All right, so
I think there is one.
Yeah, I feel like there was one.
There may have been one.
So who do we think the player of the game was? I mean, Emily Hine had the most points. I feel like Joe, when she hit that, she had some pretty clutch plays. She had that 1-3.
She broke the press really well, too.
Yeah, she did a good job breaking the press. Always finds a way to rebound, got a lot of steals. I mean, she hit that 1-3, though. I mean, that really stuck out to me. They were down by, or not down, they were up by 7. She hits a 3 with like a minute left, and she shot early. I mean, if she misses that, that's a risky shot, but she made it.
Yeah, that was.
And turned into a 10-point lead, and I think that really made the difference in the end. With them coming back, didn't really allow CSC to get any momentum. And
let's see, if she didn't make that, what would they be down? Only 3 then?
If she didn't make it? No, yeah. They would have only been up 6.
Yes.
Or 7. She pushed.
Yeah, I know. And then with CMC's comeback here, they would have only been up 3.
Sure. Well, yeah, I guess.
Because they'd be at 47-44, so they would have only been up 3, so.
Yeah, I guess.
But yeah, that's a really good hustle by both teams tonight. As one of the most exciting games we've watched. So.
Well,
I think that's about it for us tonight. So it's been Clay Bobek over here on camera, Sam Lisak, and I'm Jonah. You guys have a good night. We'll see you next time.